Hi, I'm Carrie.
And I'm Nick. And today we're going to discuss change orders. What is a construction change order, Carrie?
A change order is anything that changes post agreement signing. So once we have a contract and we have moved forward with the project, any adjustment or amendment to that is going to be a change.
All right, and so who writes the change order and gets it going?
Normally the design team will partner with construction, and sometimes that's initiated by the client and something that you want to add. I always say it's always like can lights, more can lights that people want to add. But a lot of times that is facilitated by the design, initiated kind of sometimes in the field or by the client.
Yeah, so sometimes it's a client-based, right? It's not always a bad thing that happens. They might say, hey, I want to add something additional to my project as we're going along.
Yeah, quite often. Quite often, that's the way it works.
And sometimes it is due to unforeseen circumstances, right? We can't see it all as we're going through in the field. We do our walkthroughs to try and navigate around these change orders. We'd love to have it all right up front, right? Like that's the idea. But sometimes it's unavoidable. We run into things on a remodeling basis of maybe something wasn't done correctly. Perhaps it was to code at one point, now the code has changed. And so we've got to update that and bring that up to code, right? When should be a time that a change order would be asked from a client? Is this, you know, purely based on client, or would this be also with the contractor? Maybe a subcontractor needed something that wasn't quite in the scope?
Yeah, so sometimes the client will ask that, but definitely we want to talk to your project manager or your designer to facilitate any kind of change that you're looking for, because we are managing the project for you.
You know, a lot of times we try to average cost, right? Is there something that we can allow, or maybe a cost that is typical for a change order, or can it vary dramatically?
Oh, it definitely can vary dramatically, because you may decide, oh, I didn't really want a dimmer here before, but now I do. And that may be a very minimal change order. But then we just had a project where a client says, ooh, we opened up the ceiling and now I could loft that ceiling. And wow, what an added volume that could add to the space. And we, you know, narrowed down costs for that change, and it was a beautiful addition to the project.
Yeah, and I've seen it for like cubbies. Sometimes there's hidden space in walls, mm-hmm. where we're able to maybe slide in a box cabinet or add a shelf into the space. It just helps add to the likeness of the project itself. Would a change order affect the timeline? I mean, dramatically, you know, not so much, maybe sometimes, you know, how do we go about that with our timeline and schedule?
Absolutely. Any kind of change will add to the timeline. So when you have a change, we have a great tool. We use Builder Trend, and you're going to be able to see your schedule on Builder Trend. But any changes to the scope are going to change that schedule. We will update that schedule as large changes, like lofting that ceiling, might be a little bit of work. We might have to do some framing and additional drywall work and things like that. So that may add some additional time. But there always is, any amendment is going to make some additional time that's going to be added to the final timeline of your scheduled project completion date.
I guess it varies from project to project, right? It's never going to be a one answer across the board kind of ordeal. Can we budget in change orders? I mean, is there something that we can do up front that would help to do that? Maybe leave an allowance in the project for that? Is that something that we would typically do, or that we can discuss doing with the clients?
We could, but here at Advanced Design, we really try to pinpoint all the costs as clearly and as closely as possible during our walkthrough process, during our design process, so that we don't have extras like lingering in there. As an industry, recommend that clients have approximately 5 to 10% cushion in their bank account to kind of, you know, deal with any of those unforeseen costs that may come up or that you may want to expend during the process. But from what we do, we just try to really be really accurate on.
Right, we try to eliminate them as much as possible. Exactly. Nobody wants that unexpected cost. Again, when we're adding an extra cabinet because we have the space, or medicine cabinet or something, it definitely would be nice to have that couple, you know, a dollar set aside for those projects.
there's a lot of bad stigma out there towards change orders, and it's a lot of times is one of the biggest fears that clients have going into a project. So Nick, tell me a little bit about how we handle that and how we kind of control that process.
Sure. I could understand like some of the fear that people may have with a change order. It's an added cost, it's an added expense, it's an added maybe time to the project and the schedule. Some people are following really stringent timelines. We try to make that as best as possible, you know, in the front end of it. We kind of follow a process though, right? So we try to act as quickly as we can in getting answers and whatnot for our clients. Also explaining to the homeowner what it is that we're going to do. Putting it in the most layman terms. We'll get it down on paper so everybody's an understanding of what's going to be done. Maybe even getting them out into the field and kind of pointing and showing them in their own project what it is that we need to do. We want to be as descriptive as possible, and we don't want to hide anything. We want to make sure that we're upfront, that we're honest, that it's all going to work out, and that we can generate a cost based on what it is that we're going to do. Once we're able to do that, we're able to kind of work together, you know, in the office, go over the best way to address this, write it down so that everybody's understanding, put the cost to it, and then we can send it to our clients so that they can read through it, make sure that it is what we discussed, and then sign off on it.
Yeah, and that's really important. And sometimes there's multiple solutions to something we find in the wall, you know, and we can quantify that for you and tell you how much it is to move that piece of electrical and the extra drywall work that might have happened, like in the example that Nick talked about. So there are options, and like we talk about in the beginning of our design phase, is that we try to cater all the options to you. There might be one more than one solution to that.
Sure, we spitball ideas all the time in the field to make sure that we come up with a great resolution to whatever the issue that came up is, or a proposed project of something that they'd like to have, and help mitigate that balance of what's going to happen.
Yeah, thanks for joining us today. We just really wanted to clarify and hopefully take some of the bad stigma out of change orders. And I appreciate Nick being here.
Yeah, thank you, Carrie, for joining me today. And again, if there's any question or concern about a change order, please feel free to reach out to your project manager, your designer, specialty designer, make a phone call to the studio. It's always great to have somebody to reach out to and speak with on these.